In today's video, I'm going to be sharing all the stereotypes that I've heard about Jack Russell Terriers. My dog Millie is a Jack Russell Terrier and Dachshund, but keep in mind that I have had her since she was 8 weeks old, so I have been able to like train her kind of, so these might not fit exactly to her, but I'm going to share them with you. First one is that they're too aggressive, which I don't think so, because Millie has not hurt anyone or anything. She honestly could not care about other animals, and she loves to meet new people. If anything, she's actually kind of scared of them. The next one is they don't work well with other animals, which is completely not true in Millie's case, because she has Shiba and she has a bunch of other dog friends that she hangs out with, and she doesn't care about cats. We have neighborhood cats and she just goes right past them. She could not care less, but I have had Jack Russell Terriers before that could not be friendly with anything. So this is true, but I feel like since I've had Millie since she was a puppy, it kind of helps because she's been around and introduced to more animals that way. But this is a true-ish stereotype. The next one is that they're too hyper, which is, I think, up to definition of what you think is too hyper, but yes, they are very hyper and they're very high energy and they need to be playing all the time. But Millie is also a puppy, so she still sleeps a lot. You need to be ready to play a lot if you want a Jack Russell Terrier. Next one is they're too destructive, which can be true if they're not trained. Millie is not trained, but they're very sneaky and they can compress their lungs and get through things and they will chew up everything they can. But Millie doesn't really do that. She just chews up her toys. But if they go untrained, then they might do more destruction. This one says that they're too much to care for, which I don't think is true, but like I said, in all these assumptions or stereotypes, is that a Jack Russell Terrier is like a dog breed that needs to be like high energy, and it just takes a different kind of owner to handle this. This one is, like I keep saying, very high energy, but since I've had Millie as a puppy, she has kind of been car trained, so we can go on long trips. We've taken the trip up to Maryland, which is about 4 hours, and she just sleeps the whole way. Anytime she's in a car, she just either lays down in your lap or sits in a chair and just kind of falls asleep. So it's pretty much up to the owner and how they want to train them, but they are very high energy, so this is definitely true. This one is kind of sad. It's that they'll bite you, but I do not think this is true at all for any dog. The only reason a dog would ever bite someone is if they're playing and don't mean to, or if they feel threatened in any way, which should not be the case. So this one, I don't see it being true for any dog unless given a reason. Whenever I would tell people that my dog was a Jack Russell Terrier, they would say this all the time: you do not want that dog, that's not gonna be the right fit for you, which is pretty sad, but it's true. People say that all the time about Jack Russell Terriers, but you decide what dog breed you want. You decide which one works best for you, and it's fine. This next one, obviously, again, depends on training. It's that they don't like people, but it just depends on how much you get them to interact with people and how much they're introduced to new people, and it just pretty much runs around how you handle things yourself. He actually does really well around new people and animals. This next one is that they don't like kids, and again, it depends on the dog and how they handle things. But with Millie, what I've noticed is she actually likes kids because they're usually more energetic and playful than adults, so that's something to consider. This next one is definitely true. I can attest to this completely. It's that they shed too much. I wouldn't say too much, but they definitely shed a lot. Shiba is a toy poodle and she doesn't shed, so getting Millie was definitely a wake-up call to how fur can travel that much. Next one is kind of true as well, is that they bark too much, but I wouldn't say too much, but most of the time Millie barks when she was barking, but Millie doesn't really know what she's barking at. It's kind of silly. In the end, you should always select a dog that is right for you and that will fit what you are ready to commit to, but I think that Jack Russell Terriers are a great dog to choose. So don't listen to any stereotypes, just do your own research, and thanks for watching.